The title of this writing is Unsubstantiated Beliefs. A belief is a thought repeated often enough in your head to make it second nature. So said the grasshopper many years ago. Most beliefs are another's verbal thoughts handed down to us before we even knew what a thought or a belief was. That is to say, we inherited most of our beliefs. It's come to the point that we don't think about our beliefs anymore, we just act on them. I believe it's time to turn our thinking back on when it comes to our beliefs. It was Socrates who said, "The unexamined life is not worth living." He could have just as easily said, "An unexamined belief needs to see the light of day." Have you ever done the math on the lack of evidence for many of the things we fervently believe? I believe that's how negative numbers got their start. What are you doing on automatic pilot that's heading you to a crash? That's the potential for an unexamined belief. Take a moment to list your top three beliefs. Next, notice the lack of evidence you have for them. My apologies if you listed gravity, death and taxes, and your brother-in-law not being a member of Mensa as your top three. You would be the exception rather than the rule. Most of our beliefs lack evidence, but we're forever arguing our case. It's tiring. It's time to retire the arguments. They haven't worked, aren't working now, and will never work. Arguing for your unsubstantiated beliefs is arguing for your limitations. It's more productive to examine how your beliefs are limiting you. If you're having trouble turning a corner, chances are good that an unexamined belief is blocking the way. Once you bring it into the light and pull on a loose thread or two, it begins to unravel. If your beliefs are working for you, please accept my applause. If they're causing you grief, take a closer look, and you'll remove the sinker, line, and hook. All the best, John.